Hi, I'm Steve Kelling with Ski-Doo. We've had a few customers ask us some questions on Facebook that we'd like to answer today. Okay, we had a question from Kip Zent regarding the Freeride 137. Once the 800 E-Tech is broken in, what kind of economy should one expect to get out of it with the 137 by 175 track? Is it geared differently than the Renegade Backcountry X? Well, it's geared the same as the Renegade Backcountry X, so there's no difference there. But really, when it comes down to it, the taller the lug is on the track, the less fuel economy you're going to get, because you have to move more snow or move more air with it either way. And in this one, I can't give you an exact figure, Kip, because we don't measure it that way. We typically measure trail sleds on the trail riding conditions, and we try to simulate the EPA test cycle. We have not done the off snow or in the deep snow type kind of riding to test what kind of mileage an average consumer might expect with this in the way they would use it more often than not. Because again, a free ride is used differently than a trail ride sled we use. So I don't have a good solid answer for you on that other than to say the 800 E-Tech obviously delivers better fuel economy than most other sleds out there, period. Okay, we've also had a couple questions on what are the differences between the Backcountry X and the Freeride 137. What it really comes down to is probably the chassis itself and the shocks that are on it. You've got the RS chassis right straight off of the race sled, so you got all the reinforcements there, plus you have the KYB Pro 40 shocks on it. Those are the two biggest differences in the vehicle. So again, the Freeride is one in 137 is much more aggressive, or built for a much more aggressive rider to take the hits and the big jumps that a guy might deliver there.